Hi everyone, it's Mitch. It's Saturday, December 13th. They're giving out the Heisman Trophy tonight. Before I talk about the candidates, I just want to mention that for those of you who have signed up for the free picking contest for the bowls, I've sent out the entry form. So if you haven't received it, then you might want to check your spam blockers or send me an email and I can resend it. There's still plenty of time to sign up for those people that haven't signed up yet, and I'll make sure that you guys get your entry forms. I'll be sending them out, probably batching them out once a day from here all the way until next Saturday when the games kick off finally. And boy, we can't wait for that to happen. But tonight they're giving out the Heisman Trophy. We have three finalists that will actually be there in New York, but we have probably 10 candidates that could have easily been one of the finalists. And Graham Harrell, I think he deserved a trip to New York on this one. He had an outstanding year. Michael Crabtree, Harrell's receiver at Texas Tech, another outstanding player. Sean Green. I think Ray Maluga, defensively, I think he had an outstanding year. I don't know why a defensive guy can't be the best player in America. It's so rare that it happens that a defensive guy wins the Heisman, but guys know if it was me picking it, it'd be a defensive guy winning it every single year, and I don't know if that would be so popular either. Let's just talk real quickly about the three finalists then. First guy, Colt McCoy. I went into the season, I didn't have a lot of nice things to say about Colt McCoy. I felt that last year he had been, totally inconsistent. Boy, did he prove me wrong and prove me wrong in a hurry. I don't know how many times I had to write about how wrong I was about Colt McCoy, and because I caught on early that he was onto this hot completion percentage. If you look back at my 10 top 10 lists throughout the entire season, Colt McCoy is mentioned early and often as a player of the week because of those high completion percentage games that he had. He had games where he had one or two incomplete passes, and we're not just talking about one or two games. We're talking about the bulk of the season, not just the dinks and dunks either. We're talking about, the down the field passes and watching some of those Texas games, because Texas did get a lot of airtime this year. There were times where we thought that Colt McCoy would never have an incomplete pass again, and the announcers, would say the same thing. So congratulations, Colt. You proved me wrong, and I admitted it early and often, and congratulations for making it to New York. I never thought at the beginning of the season that you would be one of the finalists. Sam Bradford, University of Oklahoma, another quarterback. Sam's, his team is outstanding. They're playing in the championship game. He had a slew of touchdowns in the high 40s touchdown passes. Bob Stoops really stepped up the pace of the Oklahoma offense and seemed to suit Sam Bradford just fine. I saw Sam Bradford last year against Miami, and we knew we were onto something special, when we saw Bradford. He just has all the throws. He's got everything. He seems to have a good head on his shoulders. If he wins it tonight, I don't think anyone is surprised. Oklahoma's been outstanding this year. They're playing in the championship game, and Sam Bradford has been a big part of it. So congratulations, Sam. The third choice is Tim Tebow, last year's winner, the University of Florida. Not quite the numbers that he had last year, but boy, was he a field general like once again, leading his team into battle each and every week. His teammates love him. The fans of college football love him. I'm a Miami fan. I'm from Miami. He's a Gator, supposedly our arch enemy. I'm a huge Tim Tebow fan. Everybody knows it. I'm not afraid to admit that, a guy who does what he does off the field, a guy who does what he does on the field, not too tough to be a fan of. I like the hard-nosed players. He's not the type of guy that's going to run out of bounds and avoid the hit. He's the guy that lowers the shoulder and delivers the blow. It's an amazing thing to see. He has a great arm. He's highly underrated in that regard, but he certainly doesn't seem to have a hard time putting up points for the Florida Gator offense, and for always being able to create a play when you can do it with your legs and do it with your arm and be the team leader that Tim Tebow is. He's my choice for the Heisman Trophy this year. Whether he wins it or not, I don't know. But what I do know is that I think he is deserving. I think he deserves to be a back-to-back winner, and I think if he comes back next year, I think he deserves it 3 years in a row, the first three-time winner of the Heisman Trophy. Not so sure he comes back. A lot of people saying he won't be a quarterback at the next level. I think that would be a big mistake to not at least let him try, because he certainly has the heart and soul, team leadership, and the respect of his teammates, and the respect of the rest of the football-watching world, which is no small feat in today where guys are shooting themselves in the leg with handguns they're carrying around. This guy goes over and does missionary work, always looking to help people. Someone that everybody looks up to, from the little kids to the oldest generation. So in any event, this is Mitch. Thanks for joining me. I'll see you in the forums. A lot of college football being talked about in there. Some college hoops. The site should be open in the next few weeks for the hoops. But in the meantime, you know, the hoops is all going on in the forum as well. So have a great day, and you know, tomorrow we'll be in the forum talking NFL football, NFL chat, and you know, next week we'll get back to making some college picks.